We're from the Latin American Coalition in Charlotte, North Carolina.
Great. And why did you guys decide to come to National Latino Advocacy Days?
Well, this is the fourth or the fifth year that the coalition participates in Advocacy Days. And we think it's so important to come to Advocacy Days, mainly because we bring our youth group, United for the Dream, and other young advocates from the Charlotte area. And for them, it's a way to empower themselves, a way for them to talk to legislators, to learn how to tell their story, to learn how to advocate for immigration reform on a much higher level. I mean, they're coming to Washington, D.C. to do that. And advocacy days and the trainings and everything that lead up to the actual meetings are extremely beneficial for these young people who we bring from North Carolina. And this year, we've also partnered up with other groups in North Carolina, El Centro Hispano, El Pueblo, and El Cambio, to bring over 45 young people from the state of North Carolina to Advocacy Days.
That's amazing.
Yeah, it is pretty amazing, and they're all super excited. They're just ready to do it. A little bit nervous, but they're all great. They got their best duds ready for tomorrow, and I think they're going to do great. One of the things that we're doing this year that's different from the past couple of years is that we've partnered up with a local artist in Charlotte, Rosalia Weiner, and she is the head of this thing called the Papalote Project. And what the Papalote Project does is it helps kids deal with family separation through art. And one of the things that she's working on this year that we are bringing to the legislators are small papalotes. And we're going to give each legislator a small papalote, and on this papalote, a kite, it has a story from a young child in the Charlotte, North Carolina area who has dealt with a family separation of some sort, being an uncle, a father, a mother, both his parents. And we were doing that to kind of establish a personal connection for the legislators that we meet with tomorrow, to show that it's not just 11 million people who are affected by immigration reform or by our broken immigration laws, but it's, you know, Jose or Raul, the 7-year-old who hasn't seen his dad in 2 years because his dad was deported. So that, bringing the Papalote Project, bringing these young people, is our way of kind of showing that immigration reform is not just this big blanket thing that Congress needs to pass. It's something that they need to pass to help families throughout this country and in Charlotte.
That's awesome. So it sounds like family reunification is definitely one of your priorities that you'd like to see in reform. Is there anything else that you want to see in an immigration reform package?
Yeah, I mean, keeping families together is the most important thing, because that's what we see every day at the Latin American Coalition. Mixed status families, everybody down here is from a mixed status family. But then the other thing that we really want to see is we want to try to find a way to integrate the undocumented population of North Carolina. You know, just a couple of years, for the past couple of years, undocumented immigrants in North Carolina have contributed over $300 million through taxes, through payroll taxes, sales tax. And what we want to do is we want to encourage the federal government to find a way to help these folks gain status and become contributing members of society, contributing members economically, socially, to start businesses, to pay taxes, to do all the things that you and I do as citizens.
Great. Well, thank you so much, Armando. It was really nice chatting with you.